Good morning, good afternoon, and good evening to everyone in the YouTube world. I have missed you guys. Today we're going to talk about my overall review, what I liked and what I didn't like on the Valiant Lady with Virgin Voyages. I really hope you guys have enjoyed the series. It was full of lots of fun times, lots of good times with other people. It was a blast, and it was a special voyage because Sir Richard Branson was on this cruise and we got to see him several times. So this is only my opinions on what I liked and what I didn't like. Please don't get offended, guys. This was my experience. And if you want to argue about it, let's go to the comments and I'll see you guys there. Now again, this was a Virgin celebration voyage and it happens 3 times a year with special guests Boy George and Richard Branson himself. It was on the Valiant Lady first, then it was on the Resilient, and then finally on the Scarlet, all within a week. This will happen every single year, so I can't wait to attend it next year for the 3rd time. I think Virgin Voyages is considered my favorite cruise line because all the right things they do, and just with a few minor things that I experienced on the ship, I can't wait to tell you guys how great this cruise was. So without further ado, let's get into what I liked and didn't like on the Valiant Lady with this Virgin celebration voyage. Now we're going to start with the customer service on Virgin Voyages. The room stewards, the staff, the bartenders were amazing. Everybody, honestly, they give you the best service they could. They were so friendly and I loved all of it. I didn't find any problems with anybody. Anytime I had a little issue, they would go straight to fix the problem. And I love the staff on Virgin Voyages. They are truly who make this cruise great. Even at the sailor services on deck 5, they were very helpful for any question that I had, even about my status, such as the deep blue extras that I have. They were super quick with answers. If they didn't have an answer at the moment, they would ask the management in the back and just come right back to me, give me an answer. And I was super happy with them. I only went there twice to ask questions, so I was in and out with no time. The next point that I loved about Virgin Voyages is the embarkation and disembarkation. So the embarkation was such a breeze. We got onto the ship with no time at all. The first time you stepped foot on the ship, I loved it all because it was such a party vibe. And then the disembarkation was even faster, really quick. You didn't even need your passport when you get off because they scan your face as you go through customs and you're on your way to Miami. So if you didn't already know, in Miami they have their own Terminal V, which belongs to Virgin Voyages, and they have the whole control of that port right there. So with the breeze getting in and out of that terminal, it was super easy, super quick, and I loved the red vibe. It was so lively, it smelled really good, and it just made you want to stay there, honestly, even before you get on the ship, or you didn't want to leave the terminal because it was so beautiful. Now the next point is the layout and how easy it is to get around the ship. It is a very large ship. It is 912 feet long, but compared to the whole cruise ships of all cruise lines, this is kind of on the small side. So regardless, it was super easy to get the elevator, to walk around the ship, take a few stairs, go this way, go that way. No issues at all because it was very walkable. I love that about Virgin. Their ships are the perfect size. Overall, guys, don't forget the Valiant Lady, the Resilient Lady, and the Scarlet Lady are all the same size. So once you get on one ship, you pretty much know the others. They all have the same layout. And this might be my most favorite point of what I love about Virgin Voyages, and that's the food within the restaurants, also the galley, all the food basically, even down to the cookies and the pastries. I loved it all. The really cool thing is that all their dining is included. I love that about Virgin. You don't have to worry about extra costs. Only on specific menus, they may have an item or two that does cost extra money, such as like lobsters or very fancy steaks. But otherwise, 99% of the menu is included at every single restaurant. Just as a pro tip, don't forget to book your restaurants 45 days in advance of your voyage, because there you can get the first slot into any of the restaurants you want. So 45 days, please keep a timer on your phone to not miss an opportunity at any restaurant on Virgin Voyages. Now my next point is the bars and the drinks on Virgin Voyages, in my opinion, again, are the best. I know I'm hyping this cruise up a lot, but you must take one. So no matter where you are, you want to grab a drink. I think the prices are reasonable. They price from anywhere from $11 to about $17 per drink, and tips are included. So you do not have to tip an extra single dollar in this cruise if you don't want to, because that's already included in your fare. Just another reason why I love Virgin. Each bar does have their own theme, so don't forget to visit the Loose Cannon and the Dockhouse. I think those are my two favorite bars, but I'm going to expand on that on a different video. Now this next point feeds into the restaurants in a way, but this is called the galley, and this is where you're going to have breakfast, lunch, and dinner all throughout your cruise. So what you do is show up to the galley, you choose any table that you want, then you scan the QR code on your table. There will be a menu for breakfast, lunch, and dinner. Once you do that, someone will come to your assistance and then you will order with them. Then after that, a few minutes later, maybe within 5 minutes, your food will be ready and it will be taken right up to you so that you can enjoy your delicious meal. Now the cool spot is the Bento Baby. They have a grab and go sushi option, but for breakfast, they also have like fruits and vegetables that you can grab and go. They also have like little refrigerators on the side so that you can grab any dessert or any sandwich on the go. What I also love about Virgin Voyages is that the little things also are included. You don't have to worry about anything else. And what I'm specifically talking about here is the water and the Wi-Fi. Can you believe that those items are actually included? Because the water is available in your room all the time, and the Wi-Fi, you can connect to it as soon as you get on the ship. So I love these little things that Virgin Voyages does not add extras to. This is just all included. You always need your water. And somebody like me that needs her Wi-Fi, it was already included in the fare as it should be. Now, the next point that I wanted to point out is that Virgin Voyages do have a wristband that you get as soon as you check in. It is pretty cool and they have different messages. Mine say, make a splash. So this thing actually controls opening the door and charging any drink or any coffee, any extras that are on the ship that are not that many to name. But you could just go like this. They have their own phone. They tag it like this. They charge you a drink, for example. So very convenient. I love it more than a card option or a lanyard option around your neck. I mean, this is awesome because it doesn't fall off of your wrist. I never lost it in the ocean and I never lost it in any other country that I was at. Virgin, you're doing great with the wristband. Please keep this. And in my most recent Virgin voyage, I actually had a central sea terrace. So that comes with the balcony. And as we've seen in the past series, I love it. It's a great option. It's very comfortable. It is very sleek, very modern. And having your own balcony, I mean, that's the best thing in the world because you can open the balcony door. You can go out there, enjoy your coffee in the morning, enjoy the ocean views. If anything, the bathroom is a little on the small side, but nonetheless, I love that room. I think it's all I need. So I just named several points that I love about Virgin, just to name a few. And after this, now we're going to talk about a few things that I didn't like about Virgin. But again, guys, this is only my opinion. Please don't fight me because Virgin is my favorite. So I only have three little points to mention about Virgin. And maybe I will have a better experience in the future. But before I mention that, please like and subscribe. And let's get on with the tiny list of what I didn't like. So my first little criticism is that the Virgin Voyages app was glitchy most of the time. And what I mean is that you would go through the app, you would kind of click through, scroll through it, and it would just go to homepage. So if I was looking for a place to go eat, it would automatically take me to homepage, and then I would have to start over, and then 20 seconds later it would do the same thing. So I actually visited with some people. I asked them the question, are you guys also having the problem with the app? And what they told me is that they also had these issues on the app. It was a little bit glitchy. Again, it would take you to different pages that you were not asking for. I love the app. It's very helpful. It's just that sometimes it was glitchy, and maybe they can fix it. This was not my first time with that experience. On my other sailings, it also had that issue. So Virgin can fix that, hopefully. Now my second tiny little criticism of Virgin Voyages are the shows. I have experienced all kinds of cruise lines, and I can say that Virgin Voyages does not have the best shows. Unfortunately, I hate saying that because I love shows, and they don't have that many in select options. But the ones that I did see, for example, the Diva Around the World, that was fine, but it was just dancing and singing and some acrobats. So in my opinion, I like to see a little more, less singing, and more things to see in the show. This is a hard one for me to say. I love shows, I love productions, but Virgin Voyages is slacking a little bit in my opinion. Now, my third criticism of Virgin Voyages is, well, first let me say that it's a hot take, and I really hope you guys do not get mad at me at this one, but you can comment below and let me know if I am super wrong at this one. But in my opinion, in my experience on this Virgin Celebration voyage, Scarlet Knight was a dud. It was not as good as I thought it was going to be. Let me explain. So before we get into it, I wanted to explain Scarlet Knight. It's basically the whole ship turning red, just all red lights all over the ship. You also wear red, so you will see us wearing a lot of red that specific night, and it's usually a sea day. This is a big party at the middle of the ship. They have different events going on inside the ship, and then later at night at about 10:30 p.m., there is one big party at the outside pool. The main pool deck has this very large party with lots of props, lots of dancers all around the swimming pool. So what I wanted to explain on this certain voyage is that Boy George himself was there. He started DJing, and from what I saw, there were dancers on the pool doing their show for about 5, not even 10 minutes, and they were just dancing. They were just doing backflips. They were just kind of getting the crowd riled up, ready to party. And within about 5 minutes, everybody in the crowd just starts jumping in the pool, just starts dancing to music. Boy George, I don't know him, and I didn't know him before this cruise, but I am not a fan of his music. He was just DJing, playing music, but I didn't find the excitement. I thought it was gonna be more of a massive, big production show, but instead it was just loud music with people partying. Maybe that's just not my vibe, but that's how Scarlet Knight went that specific cruise. Now, we did see Sir Richard Branson right next to Boy George during his DJ set, and that was pretty cool to see. But then again, maybe it's just because it wasn't my kind of music, or maybe because it was just one big party that happens every night anyway. It was pretty cool to see everybody in red. Not bad. I mean, everybody was dressed up. I loved it. I don't know. It was a letdown with Boy George on this specific voyage. So I don't know, you can roast me in the comments. Let me know what you think. So guys, I really hope you enjoyed this video with all the things that I loved and just the minor little things that I didn't love about Virgin Voyages. So again, please let me know in the comments if you have any commentary on this, if you have had a different experience. Maybe I'm just blind to it, or maybe it was an off night, I don't know. But anyways guys, thank you for watching. Please like and subscribe. I can't wait to show you guys more cruise videos. So good morning, good afternoon, and good evening to everyone in the YouTube world. Thanks for watching, guys. It means the world to me. So we'll see you guys on the next one. See ya.